Welcome to Learn 30 Tools in Fusion 360 while designing this pen series. In today's video, let us see some more options in assembly, which will help us to relate and restrict the motion of components with each other. Episode, we have seen how the changes made in the part files will be reflected in the assembly file. If we do not want this to happen, we can right click and break the link. Now the cap is an independent file and does not change when the individual file is edited. Let us open the assembly file that we have created in the past episode. I am right clicking the join from the history tree and I have clicked on edit join. Here I had previously taken rigid. So instead of that, I'm going to select slider because sliding is the motion that is going to happen between the cap and the body. So you can see I'm clicking OK. And now I'm able to move this cap up and down. But here you might be observing this flaw that it is also moving beyond this. One way to avoid this kind of interference is I can go to assemble and here I can choose enable contact sets. So here we can specify which contact should be avoided. Now I am clicking for enable all contact because I do not want any components to interfere with each other or overlap each other. So once this is activated, this component will not interfere or overlap with any other component. I'm going to right click this and go for Edit Joint Limits option. So here I'm going to set maximum and minimum limits for this. So the maximum I'm taking as 0. So the minimum will be around minus 30 and I'm going to change it to 0. So before saying OK, I can animate and I can see. So this is how I have limited my joint limits. Now after this, we will be going to the bottom portion. Now the bottom portion has two motions. One is when we are unscrewing, it should turn as well as it should move down. So I'm right clicking this edit joint and going for cylindrical option instead of slider. So with the cylindrical option, it will be rotating as well as sliding. Now for this also, I have to set the limits. So here again, from the browser under the joints, I'm going to edit joint limits. So first of all, I'm going to limit the rotate options limits. So the rotation that it should be able to rotate for 360 degrees. This actually depends upon the thread that we have given. So according to the thread, for how many revolutions, how much length it should move will be decided. So here, just for example, I'm taking 360 degrees and the amount maximum it should slide will be 10. 20 is very much higher, so I'm just changing it to 10. So here I can animate and see the sliding motion it is showing. Now to the revolve motion, it is showing only revolve. But when I right click in the browser and animate this joint, it is going to show both the options. So we have given the correct constraints and correct levels of joint limits.